Hello, welcome back to our YouTube channel AglaSem School. Today, let's dive into the religious teachings and lessons from our great mentors and devotees of Lord by discussing the back exercise of history, class 7, chapter 8, which is Devotional Paths to the Divine. So, let's get started. We will first start with some match the followings and then later discuss important teachings and practices of the various saints. 1. Match the following. A. The Buddha. The answer to this is question social differences. B. Shankar Deva. Answer to this is Namghar. C. Nizamuddin Aulia. Answer is the Sufi saint. D. Alwars. Answer is worship of Vishnu. E. Naya Nurse. Answer to this is worship of Shiva. Okay, why not answer to the missing blanks? Let's do some filling the blanks. A. Shankara was an advocate of dash. Answer is Advaita. B. Ramanuja was influenced by the dash. Answer is Alwars. C. Point is dash were the advocates of Virashivism. Answer is Basavanna, Alama Prabhu and Akhama Devi. Point D. Dash was an important center of bhakti tradition in Maharashtra. Answer is Vithala Temple. Okay, now moving towards the major part, that is the teachings and learning. Let's discuss the question and answers. So question 3 says, describe the beliefs and practices of Nathapanthis, Siddhas and Yogis. Answer is, some of the beliefs of them are stated below. Number 1, they criticize the ritual, conventional religional and social order. Number 2, instead they believe in simple and logical arguments to convey one's thought. And number 3, for them the path of salvation lies on meditation and pure meditation. Number 4, they stressed on intense training of the mind and body through yoga, breathing exercise and meditation. Kabir ke dhoye are still fresh among the talks of elder people. So why not find out what were the major ideas expressed by Kabir? How did he express these? Answer. The major ideas of Kabir are as follows. Number 1. Kabir believed in a formless supreme God. Number 2. He preached that the only path to salvation was through bhakti or devotion. Number 3. His teaching openly ridiculed all forms of external worship of both Brahmanical Hinduism and Islam, the preeminence of priestly classes and the caste system. And answer to the second part of the question is, he expressed his ideas through verses called Sakhis and Paths. Now coming to the Sufis, the question says, what were the major beliefs and practices of the Sufis? Some of the major beliefs and practices of the Sufis were, number 1, they rejected outward religiosity and emphasized love and devotion to God. Number 2, they inbuilt compassion towards all fellow human beings. Number 3, Islam propagated strict monotheism or else submission to one God. And number 4, the Sufis rejected the rituals and codes of behavior demanded by Muslim religious scholars. Let's go to question number 6. What were the major teachings of Baba Guru Nanak? Answer, Guru Nanak has given us some life-changing teachings if followed truly. And these are, there should be no discrimination of the caste system and everyone can sit together having a meal called langar. Number 2, he emphasized the importance of worship of one God. And number 3, he himself used the term Nan, Dan and Isnan for the essence of his teaching, which actually meant right worship, the welfare of others and the purity of conduct. Number 4, he was a firm believer of equality and also wanted others to inculcate and spread the same notion in society. After coming across the various practices of saints above, we can clearly feel the contradiction in some of the beliefs. So question 7 says, why do you think many teachers rejected prevalent religious beliefs and practices? Answer to this is, many teachers rejected the religious beliefs and practices on the following grounds. And these were, firstly, they were difficult to follow and cumbersome. Secondly, these practices and beliefs were spreading differences in the society. And number third is, the teachings were favoring the upper caste due to which the lower caste people were suffering. Okay, so coming to question number 8. For either the Virashivas or the saints of Maharashtra, discuss their attitude towards caste. So, the answer to this is, the attitude of Virashivas towards caste was that they argued strongly for the equality of all human beings and against Brahmanical ideas about caste and treatment of women. They were also against all forms of rituals and idol worship. Question number 9. Why do you think ordinary people preserve the memory of Mirabai? Answer 9 is, many ordinary people can connect to the memory of Mirabai because of the many apt reasons, and these are, she was a divine devotee of Lord Krishna and wrote numerous bhajan showing intense devotion towards him. Number 2, her songs openly challenged the norms of upper caste. They gradually became popular in the masses of Rajasthan and Gujarat. That's all for today, and I hope you all have understood the chapter and solution. In case you have any doubts in any of the questions discussed in the video, do reach us by posting your queries in the comment section below. And for more NCERT videos, do subscribe AglaSem School. Thank you.